All right, so what is going on, YouTube? It is J3Times. We are back at it with another reaction video. And today, of course, I'm going to react to A Few Good Men. I have never seen this movie before, and I figure why not wear something similar to the movie? So the Marines wore their service alphas during the video. So I figure why not I wear my service alphas and react to the video just to give it a different feel for this video. You know, because normally my reaction videos, I always wear regular clothes, you know, regular attire. So I figured, why not switch it up? So, hey, definitely gotta see this movie to the fullest. Never ever seen this movie before. But I've seen some scenes, and this movie's really, really good. I've been asleep this entire time. Anyways, I'm not talking anymore. Let's get straight into it. Sorry, y'all. Oh my goodness. I'm awful. All right, hold up. I'm a hot mess right now. All right, I'm sorry. Oh, good Lord. Oh, goodness gracious. I'm a mess. I'm sorry. Chair. It's messed up. Okay, this is crazy, y'all. Like, the opening scene already, like, what are they doing? They went into this Marine's room and they start jacking him up while he's sleeping. Let's keep watching. Duct tape, bro, they duct tape his feet. Duct tape his mouth. Like, what in the world? Bro. Obviously, right there, we see that's a silent drill platoon. Just the sound of those weapons. Oh, it just sounds something so satisfying about hearing the weapons being smacked. Whew, boy, you get chills.
Medical next week.
Tell your friend not to get cute down there. The Marines in Guantanamo are fanatical.
About what?
About being Marines.
Dear sir, my name is PFC William T. Santiago. I'm a Marine.
Oh, hold up. Is he writing a letter? to an officer? And did he say, dear sir? I don't think he agreed. First of all, you skipped the entire chain of command. Second of all, you don't start off with the dear sir with anything. Like, I don't care if you're emailing, you don't care if you're writing a letter, I don't care if you're texting, you don't start with the dear sir. It's a proper greeting. Good morning, sir. Okay, I just want to add that. Let's continue.
My unit here in Cuba, and to ask for your help. I've fallen out on runs before for several reasons, such as feeling dizzy or nauseated. But on May 18th, I've fallen back about 20 or 30 yards, going down a rocky, unstable hill. My sergeant grabbed me and pushed me down the hill. Then I saw all black, and the last thing I remember is hitting the deck. I was brought to the hospital where I was told I just had heat exhaustion. I ask you to help me.
That's crazy. His sergeant is going to let him drop like that? Like, hold up. First of all, my question is, like, why? Is he hazing him? I think he's hazing him. Like, was that hazing? Because, he had that whole platoon running, and then he was picking him out. He was running next to him. Then he let him fall, and he's still screaming at him. I don't know what's up with that. That's crazy.
I just need to be transferred out of RSC. Sincerely, PFC William T. Santiago, U.S. Marine Corps. P.S. In exchange for my transfer off the base, I'm willing to provide you with information
about
an
illegal fence line shooting that occurred the night of August the 2nd. Who the fuck is PFC William T. Santiago?
Private Santiago is a member of 2nd Platoon Bravo, sir.
Yeah. Well, apparently he's not very happy down here at Shangri-La because he's written letters to everybody but Santa Claus asking for a transfer. And now he's telling tales about a fence line shooting. Matthew?
I'm appalled, sir.
You're appalled. This kid broke the chain of command and ratted on a member.
I'm glad he said it. I'm glad they mentioned that. Like, he literally did skip the entire chain of command. Like, there is, like, you don't just go out and just write letters to officers. You don't go out and just text or even email. You don't just go out and talk to officers whenever you feel like it. There's a chain of command, and there's a chain of command for a reason. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
...of his unit to say nothing of the fact that he is a U.S. Marine, and it would appear he can't run from here to there without collapsing from heat exhaustion. What the fuck is going on in Bravo Company, Matthew?
Colonel, I think perhaps it would be better to hold this discussion in private.
That won't be necessary, Colonel. I can handle this situation, sir.
The same way you handled the Curtis Bell incident?
Sir, my methods of leadership...
Don't interrupt me, Lieutenant! I'm still your superior officer.
And I'm yours, Matthew. I want to know what we're going to do.
Yeah, they definitely acted like, yeah, this is good. Like, they act like they're aware that, you know, there is a rank structure, and they're aware that they gotta treat the other rank with a certain amount of respect, you know. Cause I don't know if y'all see like other movies. Like, I'm gonna give you one perfect example: Megan Levy. Like, bro, there was no respect for like rank at all. I don't know what's up with that, but like Hollywood, I don't know y'all. But at least right here in this scene. At least I'm glad, like, in this movie, they know rank is a thing and respect is a thing. So, this is good. This is good, y'all.
Good. It's gonna be fine.
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Santiago, I was William's executive officer. I knew your son vaguely, which is to say I knew his name. In a matter of time, the trial of the two men charged with your son's death will be concluded, and 7 men and 2 women whom you've never met will try to offer you an explanation as to why William is dead. For my part, I've done as much as I can to bring the truth to light. And the truth is this: your son is dead for only one reason. I wasn't strong enough to stop it. Always, Lieutenant Colonel Matthew Andrew Markinson, United States Marine Corps.
Bro,
his
man shot himself. What? Wow, that's crazy. I mean, that's like, I feel like I shouldn't be so surprised, because suicide does happen in the military. Like, that's a real thing, y'all. Like, suicide is the real thing. Like, you know, people do kill themselves, especially in the Marines, y'all. So, but it's just, dang, dog. He just shot himself with a gun. Like, man, that's not something I expected, bro. Like, dang. Dang. He getting all dressed up and everything. Crazy.
Colonel, I have just one more question before I call Airman O'Malley and Airman Rodriguez. If you gave an order that Santiago wasn't to be touched, and your orders are always followed, then why would Santiago be in danger? Why would it be necessary to transfer him off the base?
Santiago was a substandard Marine. He was being transferred.
That's not what you said. You said he was being transferred because he was in grave danger.
That's correct.
You said he was in danger. I said grave danger. You said, is there any
other... I recall what I said.
I can have the court reporter read back to you.
I know what I said. I don't have to have it read back to me like I'm...
Why the two orders? Colonel?
Sometimes men take matters into their own hands.
No, sir. You made it clear just a moment ago that your men never take matters in their own hands. Your men follow orders or people die. So Santiago shouldn't have been in any danger at all, should he have, Colonel?
You snotty little bastard.
Your Honor, I'd like to ask for a recess.
I'd like an answer to the question, Judge.
Oh, man, he getting upset now. So I guess, I don't know the whole plot of the movie, y'all, but I'm assuming he's getting caught with something. Involving a death, obviously somebody died, and that's funny. Snidin' those little
recess.
I'd like an answer to the question, Judge.
The court will wait for an answer.
If Lieutenant Kendrick gave an order that Santiago wasn't to be touched, then why did he have to be transferred, Colonel? Lieutenant Kendrick ordered the code red, didn't he? Because that's what you told Lieutenant Kendrick to do.
Object!
And when it went bad, you cut cases. These guys loose!
Your Honor!
You had Marcus inside a bony transfer!
Your Honor!
You doctored the logbook!
Damn it, Captain!
You coerced the doctor!
Consider yourself in contempt!
Colonel Jessup! Did you order the code red?
You don't have to answer that question.
I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled to.
You want answers!
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
Good Lord, this is some... This is some top-notch acting right here, y'all. From these two gentlemen, y'all. These are some... Jack Nicholson and Tom Cruise. This is some top-notch actors, y'all, right here. This... It killed this scene, y'all. I ain't gonna lie to you. Hey, it killing this scene. Like, for real.
In a world that has walls, and those walls have to be guarded by men with guns. Who's gonna do it? You? You, Lieutenant Weinberg?
That's funny, he's gonna throw the other lieutenant in the conversation, like, she wasn't even part of it. He's gonna throw it in there. You, Lieutenant Weinberg, like, just let me stay over there, dog, you know? Just, bruh, that's funny.
I have a greater responsibility.
Man, salty.
Than you can possibly fathom. You weep for Santiago and you curse the Marines. You have that luxury. You have the luxury of not knowing what I know, that Santiago's death, while tragic, probably saved lives. And my existence, while grotesque and incomprehensible to you, saves lives. You don't want the truth because deep down in places you don't talk about at parties, you want me on that wall. You need me on that wall. We use words like honor, code, loyalty. We use these words as the backbone of a life spent defending something. You use them as a punchline.
Dang, boy. Straight came from the Navy, bro. We use those words to defend something. What'd he say? You know, like, to defend some... I said it backwards. So he said, we use those words as the backbone to defend something. You use those words as a punchline. Navy? I mean, that's crazy, because we are... actually a department of the Navy, technically, you know, but hey, Shout out to the Navy. Shout out to Marines all across the world.
I have neither the time nor the inclination to explain myself to a man who rises and sleeps under the blanket of the very freedom that I provide and then questions the man.
Dang, boy, you really throwing salt in the Navy, bro. Throwing salt in the Navy, bro. Throw a whole bunch of shade in the Navy, bro. Say so you lay in the blanket of the freedom that I provided, the Marines provided. Dang, bro. Dang, boy, holding that over his head, bro. Crazy, boy.
Questions the manner in which I provide it. I would rather you just said thank you and went on your way. Otherwise, I suggest you pick up a weapon and stand a post. Either way, I don't give a damn what you think you are entitled to.
Did you order the code red?
I did the job.
Did you order the code red?
You're goddamn right I did.
Ooh, sheesh. Yo, the acting, yo. The camera angles. Oh my goodness, bro. Yo, I gotta watch this movie to the fullest, cause this obviously, like, from what I'm seeing right here, is amazing. Like, it looks amazing. Look, like, literally, like, the accuracy, the uniforms, like, the way they're speaking to each other, like, bro, everything just looks so good. Like, it looks like a top-notch military movie right here, y'all. Like, literally, a top-notch military movie that I apparently have been sleeping on, because this is definitely a popular movie. Box office is pretty high, so, I mean, hey, I gotta watch this to the fullest. Like, probably after I'm done this video. Probably, maybe, we'll see. Hey, y'all, but I'm gonna finish the rest of this reaction. We're almost done.
Harold? Sir? You don't need to wear a patch in your arm to have honor.
Ten Hut!
There's an officer on deck.
Cringing. That was just a little cringing right there. Like, what? He just turned around and said, Ten Hut! Officer on deck. Salute out of cover. Like, what? Bro, he has no cover on his head. You never salute without a cover. Let's get that straight. You don't got a cover in your head, you do not salute. let's get that straight. And what's with all the shouting, bro? And, you know, officer on deck. Like, I would understand he had a billet, but you know, he's a lieutenant, you know. He's just one of the lieutenants. One of the many officers in the room, you know? I mean, like I say, if he held a billet, a high billet, that would make more sense for him to, you know, be shouting, officer on deck, a 10 hut, all that, you know. But yeah, man. Anyways, that's the first reaction video. That was definitely, so far from what I've seen, really, really great, y'all. Like that movie. I gotta watch the movie, y'all. I got to. That's a really great military movie. Anyway, you guys, I hope you liked the video. Hope I brought a little something different with the uniform. Give a little different feel. Anyways, like, comment, subscribe. Stay tuned for more content. It's your boy, J3Times. I'm checking out. Peace.